The modern history of natural gas in Europe kicked off in 1959 with the discovery of the Groningen field in the Netherlands, followed by the first discoveries in the UK sector of the North Sea a few years later. Substantial discoveries of gas in the Norwegian sector then followed in the 1970s, and although the UK had a huge domestic market, Norway did not have the population size to use all their resources, and so created a hugely successful export business, with pipelines delivering gas to both the UK and continental Europe. At this point, Russia was not yet a key player on the stage of natural gas exportation. Although the Soviet Union had been exporting small quantities of natural gas to Poland since the late 1940s, large-scale exports into Western Europe were not on the table, for both logistical and economic reasons. Instead, they focused on moving gas from Ukraine and the North Caucasus to Siberia, which required transportation across several thousand kilometers. That issue of long-distance transportation was eventually solved in the 1970s, when supergiant Siberian gas fields were discovered at Yamburg, Medvezhe, and Urengoy, allowing for production to take place locally. Multiple large-diameter pipelines were then built from Siberia to Ukraine, and from there, only a short extension was required for one or two pipelines to reach Europe. From 1970 to 1980, Soviet gas delivery to Western Europe ramped up, increasing from 3.4 to 26 billion cubic meters. Once the 90s rolled around, gas exports had risen to a whopping 109 billion cubic meters, making Western Europe the largest natural gas buyer from the Soviet Union. In today's world, natural gas availability is vital to the survival of Europe, and the supply-demand fundamentals in place highlight the importance of Russia as a partner. While the current energy policy in the EU is forward-thinking in its targets for renewable energy and emission reduction, it is woefully unprepared for the security threat of increased dependence on natural gas from Russia. As of 2008, the European Union imported 50% of its energy requirements in the form of hydrocarbons, and projections out to 2030 predict these imports will rise to 70% of all energy consumed in the EU. A number of factors are driving the increased reliance on external sources of hydrocarbon energy, but chief among them is the fact that the majority of European oil and gas resources are either depleted or in serious decline. Aside from Russia, prospects for meaningful domestic European production seem to be, at this point, nothing more than a pipe dream. The farther east one goes in Europe, the greater the reliance on gas imports from Russia, to the extent that seven former Warsaw Pact and Soviet Union countries rely on Russia for 99% of their natural gas requirements. In addition, nearly all Central and Eastern European countries depend on Russian gas imports for the majority of their consumption. With the recent full-scale invasion of Ukraine by Russia, doubts have been cast on the role that Russian energy has to play, and some very strict sanctions are being levied by many countries, both in Europe and in places like the United States and Canada. One of the biggest sanctions is the halting of the Nord Stream 2 pipeline, which was designed to double the flow of gas from Russia into Germany. Ironically, it was Germany who opted to deny themselves much-needed gas supplies as their own electricity costs continue to rise. This caused Dmitry Medvedev, Russia's former president and now deputy chairman of its Security Council, to declare, "Welcome to the new world, where Europeans will soon have to pay 2,000 euros per 1,000 cubic meters." He may be right. But regardless, we can see just how fragile the energy situation is across the whole region at the moment. How this plays out in the years ahead will be fascinating and potentially tragic to observe, as we still don't have a firm grasp on when the conflict in Ukraine will end or just how bad it will get. Natural gas prices in Europe have already risen massively, spiking parabolically to 180 euros per megawatt hour in December of 2021, before dropping down to around 70 euros, still a huge increase when we consider that it was only 4 euros in May of 2020. Pile on top of this, the absolutely moronic decision to phase out nuclear energy in countries like Germany and Austria and replace it with unreliable wind and solar, and a lot of Europe may be in for a great deal of pain and even fatalities due to the lower income brackets being unable to afford heating in the coldest months of winter. This is certainly a grim scenario that we're seeing play out, but let's hope cooler heads prevail, and perhaps through a reorganization of the political landscape, energy prices can be made more affordable for all citizens across the European continent, and violent wars can become a thing of the past. We can only hope. Commodity Culture is a series that covers the history and culture surrounding commodities and natural resources. If you enjoyed this episode and want to see more, please subscribe and hit the bell notification to ensure you are always alerted of the latest episodes.